Hello, everyone. Hello. My glasses on. A warm welcome to you all on this cold winter afternoon. I'm Dr. Ros Taylor, a hospice doctor for 30 years, but only 2 years at Michael Sobell and Harlington, where I have been honoured to help rebuild the team to open the hospice again in January 2020. Everyone today has a unique and precious connection to the hospice, but also to someone special whom you are honouring and remembering this afternoon. This time of year is a time of celebration, but also a time when we notice the gaps at the table, and the gaps seem bigger and louder than ever this year. I'm joining you in remembering, as this year I lost my precious 31-year-old daughter, Phoebe, in February. I get huge comfort from thinking of the gifts that Phoebe left me, gifts from her whole life. These gifts have already started to help me to heal the enormous wound that is grief that I know many of you here, all of you here, are feeling. Grief is like a wound. In fact, the word bereaved comes from the word bereft, which means torn open. And we know that wounds heal best if they are left open. And I suggest that the grief wound starts to heal with the gifts that we've been left. Phoebe's gifts to me include many. They include her amazing humour, her love of languages and words, her love of books, her love of purple, which I'm wearing today, her love of ice cream, and many other things. But most of all, her gift was her love. I can say 9 months on that honouring and remembering these gifts has helped the healing. In fact, I was thinking the other day about the word loss. I lose things all the time, and many of you who work with me will know that. When we lose things, we often feel confident that they're still somewhere close. We just don't know where. And it's the same when we lose people. They're in a different place, but often not so far away. We just don't know where. They're not really lost. It's a strange word. Many will know these words, often read at funerals. I'm waiting for you somewhere very near, just around the corner. The other thing that worries me, often out of the blue when I least expect it, is the thought that I didn't love Phoebe enough. This is echoed in a story of one of our patients this year. The family may be here, but I'm sure they won't mind me telling the story. We cared for this person for 6 months, on and off, in the hospice. We never felt as a team that we were doing enough to help his suffering. But as death approached, he repeatedly thanked us for what we had done for him, and his family have continued with thanks since he died. The most we did was to be there. We didn't abandon him, and this is what he valued so much. So it's good to remember that we are human beings, not human doings. And one of the most precious things we do is just to be there for our loved ones and friends. So when you feel helpless or wished you'd done more, don't be so hard on yourself. Remember that your presence was a present, a gift. So thank you for coming today, and remember the gifts you've been left and the gifts you gave. Billy Bragg, in his song, We Laughed, I do recommend that you look that up on the internet, was written with a hospice patient. And some of the words say, the hardest part of living is giving up what has been given. And you know no one could love you more, whatever the future has in store. And I want you to remember that we laughed. I know my daughter would want me to laugh. So thank you for your support of the hospice. And one final message from a patient we cared for a few months ago, from Harry. I arrived at Michael Sobell tired, dejected, and not knowing what the future held. I was discharged 14 days later with a spring in my step, having had my medication tweaked and my confidence restored. Harry returned for care later in the year for his final days, but I'm glad we gave him some extra time. Your support today, in the future, and in the past will give so many more some extra time. Time that will allow us to continue to care quietly and consistently for those who need us. Thank you.
Instructions by Arnold Crompton. When I have moved beyond you in the adventure of life, gather in some pleasant place and there remember me with spoken words old and new. Let a tear if you will, but let a smile come quickly, for I have loved the laughter of life. Do not linger too long with your somnolities. Go eat and talk, and when you can, follow a woodland trail, climb a high mountain, walk along the wild seashore, chew the thoughts of some book which challenges your soul. Use your hands some bright day to make a thing of beauty or to lift someone's heavy load. Though you mention not my name, though no thoughts of me cross your mind, I shall be with you, for these have been the realities of my life for you. And when you feel some crisis with anguish, when you walk alone with courage, when you choose the path of right, I shall be very close to you. I have followed the valleys and I have climbed the heights of life.
Miss Me, But Let Me Go by Christina Rossetti. When I come to the end of the road and the sun has set for me, I want no rights in a gloom-filled room. Why cry for a soul set free? Miss me a little, but not for long, and not with your head bowed low. Remember the love that once we shared. Miss me, but let me go. For this is a journey we all must take, and each must go alone. It's all part of the master plan, a step on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick at heart, go to the friends we know. Laugh at all the things we used to do. Miss me, but let me go.
We Remember Them by Sylvan Caymans and Jack Weimer. At the rising of the sun and at its going down, we remember them. At the blowing of the wind and in the chill of winter, we remember them. At the opening of the buds and in the rebirth of spring, we remember them. At the blueness of the skies and in the warmth of summer, we remember them. At the rustling of the leaves and in the beauty of autumn, we remember them. At the beginning of the year and when it ends, we remember them. As long as we live, they too will live, for they are now a part of us as we remember them. When we are weary and in need of strength, we remember them. When we are lost and sick at heart, we remember them. When we have joy we crave to share, we remember them. And when we have decisions that are difficult to make, we remember them. When we have achievements that are based on theirs, we remember them. As long as we live, they too will live, for they are now a part of us as we remember them.
Through the wood, who can say I've been changed? In Lieu of Flowers by Shauna Linnae. Although I love flowers very much, I won't see them when I'm gone. So, In Lieu of Flowers, buy a book of poetry written by someone still alive. Sit outside with a cup of tea, a glass of wine, and read it out loud, by yourself or to someone, or silently. Spend some time with a single flower, a rose maybe, smell it, touch the petals, really look at it. Drink a nice bottle of wine with someone you love, or champagne, and think of what John Maynard Keynes said, "My only regret in life is that I did not drink more champagne." Or what Dom Perignon said when he first tasted the stuff, "Come quickly, I am tasting stars." Take out a paint set and lay down some colours. Watch birds. Common sparrows are fine. Pigeons too. Geese are nice. Robins. In lieu of flowers, walk in the trees and watch the light fall into it. Eat an apple, a really nice big one. I hope it's crisp. Have a long soak in the bathtub with candles. Maybe some stoop and watch the clouds. Have a dish of strawberry ice cream in my name. If it's winter, have a cup of hot chocolate outside for me. If it's summer, a big glass of ice water. If it's autumn, collect some leaves and press them in a book you love. I'd like that. Sit and look out a window and write down what you see. Write some other things down. In lieu of flowers, I would wish for you to flower. I wish for you to blossom, to open, to be beautiful.
The unfinished. We cannot judge a biography by its length, nor by the number of pages in it. We misjudge it by the richness of its contents. Sometimes those unfinished are amongst the most poignant. We cannot judge a song by its duration, nor by the number of its notes. We must judge it by the way it touches and lifts our souls. Sometimes those unfinished are among the most beautiful. And when something has enriched your life, and when its melody lingers on in your heart, is it unfinished or is it endless? Okay, so it's now come to the time for the lighting of the lights. So you should all have a little tea light in your bag. If you don't have a tea light, please put your hand up and the team can bring one round for you. Just so you know, the lights will dim down and then you can all switch on your tea lights. So we will now have a moment of quiet for remembrance and reflection. Following that, the outside lights will be turned on. So if we can now dim the lights. Okay, if the main lights can go on now, thank you. So I'd just like to say, before the choir do their last song, because we are approaching that time, I just want to like a big thank you to the fundraising team for organising this event, to all the readers for reading, and a huge big thank you to Lemon Tuesday for joining us. I'm sure you'll agree they've been truly amazing, as always. And I personally am really
welcoming you back with open arms. It's so lovely to have you back here. Last year wasn't quite the same. So it's lovely. Thank you very much. But lastly, I would like to thank each and every one of you for coming this evening. As was said earlier in this cold winter's evening. But after, please join us for a cup of tea, cup of coffee, hot chocolate, and a mince pie. You're all more than welcome.
Thank you.